What's up, everybody? Welcome to Money Management Channel. My name is Andrei, and today I'm going to be doing an update on BBIG ticker. And in today's video, first of all, I will show you where we are on the price chart and how we get there. Then I will continue with the fundamental news that might affect the price of this company. And at the end of this video, I will share my thoughts about upcoming price action. So let's start with the price chart. I made my previous video right here at this point, and I've told you that we have to hold this previous bottom, this support line, at the level of around $7.59. Next support line might be this previous swing low at the range of $6.93. And the next one is this range in between the 0.65 and 0.618 levels. It is a Fibonacci retracement levels from the very bottom to the very top. And it is also a confluence level with this previous top at the range of at the level of $6.04. So, and as you can see, we had a very good reaction right here at this very point. We touched it, bounced back. If I switch to 15 minutes time frame, you will see more thoroughly. As you can see, we touched it, then bounced back. And we had this level that was previously a support, and for now it acts as a resistance. We had one touch right here, but then bounced back, another touch right here, and eventually we went lower even than this $6.93 support line. And at this point, this line became a resistance, and as you can see, we touched this level that becomes a support of around $6, then retested from the top. And for now, we have more chances, unfortunately, to go south because we have consistently lower highs and lower lows. So we are on downtrend, and I will share my thoughts and my technical analysis just in several minutes. And for now, let's continue with the fundamentals of this company. So, their numbers are not so impressive, and I have to say that for now, its total market cap is $658.58 million. They have a revenue of $13.91 million with negative net income of more than $250 million. They don't have enough cash to cover all these losses. They have only $75.65 million. And that is why, and I mentioned it in my previous video, from the financial standpoint, this is not the best company. So let me show you some news related to this company. And we are on Investor Place, and this article was published 13 hours ago, and it's titled Vinco Ventures combines several elements young investors love. And I have to say that these elements are the competitor of TikTok. It is Lamotiv, and they have NFT. That might be a next big thing, but for now it is more speculative rumors around all of these non-fungible tokens. And third one is the crypto and crypto tide. That should be another major point that might drive the price of this ticker. But unfortunately, right here, let me quote you this article. It will all end in tears for Vinco Ventures. And this article was published one day ago. And let me quote you this. Right here, you can find that one of the person who is behind the BBIG company is Ted Farnsworth. And he has not the best renommé in the financial world, because previously he made a company, and I covered it in one of my previous video. This company was the Movie Pass, and a lot of people lost their money. They lost more than $250 million in 2018, and that is why Ted is not the best person who might be behind the scenes of BBIG company. And that is why you have to be cautious. On top of that, let me show to you that on this article, according to this article, and it was published on fxstreet.com, it's titled BBIG Stock News, Vinco Ventures Keep Falling as Key Deadline Nears. And major key points are right here, and I want to pay your attention only on this one. Vinco Ventures is still believed to be one of the best chances for another short squeeze. And let me show you that for now, this company has the short volume ratio is only 28.06 according to FINRA, and it has a short borrow fee rate at the range of 26.26%. It's not the lowest one, but definitely it is not the highest. And it has more than 200,000 shares available for short. And that is why, in my opinion, it is not so probable that we might see next short squeeze, especially if we will take a look on, for example, kivercount.com, and this website tracks all the activity around Wall Street Bets community. And we all know that Wall Street Bets community is the main catalyst for the potential short squeezes. And among the list of most mentioned tokens, we don't have a BBIG ticker so far. And if we will scroll down to the very bottom, and right here we'll try to find the BBIG ticker, we will see that it has only 3 mentions, and it is near to nothing if you compare it with the top tickers that might be the short squeezed. So, and that is why you have to be extremely cautious with this ticker, and let's continue with the technical analysis. So guys, as I already mentioned in my previous video, and I've told you, if we would break this level of support at the range of $6.93, we have much less probability to hit our target at $12.52, previous swing high, and our major target for this ticker at the range of $16.67. And I have to say that for now I am more bearish than bullish with this ticker, and right here we found quite decent support, but unfortunately we don't have enough evidence to go higher, because on 4-hour time frame the RSI is pointing down, and we also don't have any bullish signs on different time frames related to RSI and MACD indicator. We are hovering in the neutral territory, and this means we have a room to move south. On 1-hour time frame, some of you might think that we have a bullish divergence. We have higher lows on RSI with the lower lows on the price action. But this pattern won't work, because as you can see, it is on 1-hour time frame, and these two bottoms has a huge distance between it. It has more than 5 days, and on a 1-hour time frame, we cannot have this pattern as a bullish divergence. And on top of that, in between these two levels, we were hovering in the neutral territory. This means this oversold RSI was completely unloaded, and that is why we cannot rely on this pattern as a bullish divergence. So, what to expect next? If you still believe that this company might hit the targets at the range of $12.52 or even higher, then it's up to you, but I don't think that this risk to reward ratio is favorable for the position in this company. And that is why I have to say that if we will break this range, the range in between 0.618 and 0.65 levels, it will definitely indicate that we lost the entire momentum for this ticker. And for now, this company becomes an ordinary company with weak fundamentals and with weak intentions to move higher. And that is why you have to be cautious with the investment and with the swing trades in this company. So, I think from the technical standpoint, that's it for now. Just be extremely cautious, and remember that I might be completely wrong. My win rate is 70 to 75%, but still, majority of my predictions became a reality, and that is why you can rely on my analysis as a part of your own due diligence. So, if you like my video, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel with notification bell, and see you guys and girls next time. Bye!